Everyone, my name is Lindsay and welcome to my channel. I am so glad you decided to join me here on my channel. I basically talk a lot about my roller skating rink opening adventure, fitness, diabetes, health, keto, whatever. This is kind of a random channel. I don't know, random, but a lot of it has to do with my documentary, me following my journey on opening a roller skating rink here in my hometown. So anyways, if you're new here, welcome. Nice to meet you. I am so happy you decided to stick around and see what kind of crazy I got going on here. And if you are not new here and you've been here for a while, thank you so much for coming back and being a part of my family here on YouTube. I don't know, we don't have a special name for us yet because, you know, all good YouTubers have their own special names, but we'll figure it out. So anyways, so today I'm going to talk about my epic road trip with my friend and derby wife to Salem, Ohio, where we got 350 plus pairs of skates. Now, it was a crazy trip, and there is so much to talk about, and I did vlog while I was on the trip, so I will probably make another video about that or include it in this one. I think I'll include it in this one because it'll just be easier. So, anyways, I'll give you kind of an overview of what we did, and then I'll put the vlog in, and yeah, so I guess let's just jump right into the video. Okay, so me and my derby wife, Michelle, went on a long road trip to pick up 350 plus pairs of roller skates. So I did not have to buy new roller skates. We went to a Salem Fun Center in Salem, Ohio, and it's just kind of south of Rockford, or no, not Rockford, Streetsboro, Ohio, kind of west of Akron. So if you are from Ohio or know anything about that, that's kind of where it is. Salem, Ohio itself is like this kind of little small town. Like, I think it's smaller than Watertown, but it's still bigger than, it's about probably like 10,000 people is my estimations if I saw and did my research right. But it's a little town, but it was very cute. And the streets were extremely narrow, pulling that trailer behind my Envoy, which made me very nervous, but we prevailed. From the whole beginning of this, when I look back at my statistics here, which I just wrote them down because it was crazy. I feel like kind of crazy for doing this. We traveled 2,068 miles there and back. We went through 5 states, which was Minnesota, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, and then finally Ohio. We wanted to just make like a pit stop to Pittsburgh, but my whole timeline got messed up from the trip and it was just backed up for the whole trip, which sucks, but we did 5 states, not including South Dakota because we live here, and the total travel time was 34 hours and 23 minutes. That was just driving time. If you didn't know, Google Maps, if you have an account, I'm a faithful Google user. I just am. Obviously, I'm on YouTube. I have Gmail. I have Google Maps. But Google Maps, basically, it sounds kind of creepy, but I think it's cool. But it tracks and tracks your trips and gets the statistics for them. It says how long you went, how long you drove for, all that stuff. So I was able to look back in my Google Maps and say, okay, this is how much I traveled. this day. This is how much I traveled this day. So yeah, I drove 34 hours and 23 minutes. It was crazy. I would be driving for one of the longest legs of the trip was 12 hours, and that was so long. Excuse me, I haven't made a video in a while, and apparently I forgot how to talk. So one of the legs of the trip was 12 hours, and that was from when we were going to the cities to Salem, Ohio. We did that in one day because we stopped at the cities. When I say the cities, I mean like St. Paul, Minneapolis area. That in our area is the cities. So when I say the cities, that's what I mean. So we stopped in the cities for our first night because it was like getting pretty late. And fun fact, the trailer lights didn't work. And I didn't know until we got to the hotel and checked them and were like, no, they don't work. This is making me nervous driving at night. I can't, you know, tell if people know my car light, my lights on my mirror for my blinkers worked. I didn't know if people could see that. And so I was like, I don't know. I really wanted to keep going, but then we kind of did want to stop because we were tired and just like, it was nerve-wracking driving at night in Minnesota. So we decided to stop in the cities for the night and got a hotel room there. And it was nice. They had like breakfast buffet and they had a pool, but no hot tub. Like that's the one thing we wanted was pools with hot tubs, but apparently that's not a thing in Minnesota or Ohio, because we could only find hotels with pools. Can you tell me the hotels in your area have pools with, I should say hot tubs with their pools, or just regular pools with no hot tubs? I don't know, like that's weird to me, because in South Dakota every hotel that has a pool has hot tub. It's like peanut butter and jelly. That's just a little complaint I had though, so just ignore that. So we then traveled from the cities to Salem, Ohio, but actually we went to Streetsboro first to make our stop Saturday night because we did not make it to the skating rink in time by Saturday night because they closed at 11 and it was just too late. And I'm kind of glad in retrospect that we decided to do that. So yeah, and then we got the skates Sunday morning. We toured the facility. I took a video of that just because it was really cool, and I take notes for how I want to have my skating rink be, like what they're doing that looks like it works well, I want to do well also because they're obviously successful. So I took video of the skating rink and I'll probably put some of the video in there, probably not all of it. And we got the skates, pulled the trailer with us with a ton of skates. They were in Home Depot boxes and the boxes practically just break. Like, they're nice Home Depot cardboard boxes, but they don't handle like 80 pounds of skates very well. So we went to, let's see, where did we go after that? Oh, so that was Sunday. So then Sunday we traveled to Madison, Wisconsin. And I have to say, Wisconsin is very nice, very hilly, very scenery. I loved the scenery in Wisconsin, and they were the only state out of all the six states that I've been in now that have Sierra Mist Zero in a 20-ounce bottle. I know, stupid complaint, but nobody anywhere has a 20-ounce bottle of Sierra Mist Zero, and that's like my one favorite pop now that I'm keto, because it's like clear and there's not a whole lot of additives to it, and it's just good and I love it. So anyways, side note there. So then we went to Madison, Wisconsin. We stayed the night. They had a pool and a hotel. Pool and a hotel. Oh my God. They had a pool and a hot tub. So we kind of relaxed. And then yesterday morning came about and we got ready, did our makeup, just had a very calm, quiet morning. Well, I don't want to say quiet. My Derby wife is a realtor and she had some like business she was dealing with. So she was a little fired up with that. That's all I'm going to say on that. But it was still a nice morning. And then I'm like, ooh, how do you feel about going to Sephora? So we made a little trip to Sephora. It got some stuff because I needed some brow pomade. And got some Take Off the Day makeup remover balm from Clinique. I heard it works great. And mascara, like, sticks on me forever. It never comes off of me, no matter what it is. I don't know if it's the brands I use or what, but I heard good things about it, so I'm like, I want to try it. So I got some of that, and I also got Huda Beauty, the little green emerald palette, because I'm really, really feeling like the color green lately, and I don't really have a lot of greens in my collection right now. I really wish Tarte came out with that Icy Bitch palette, because I would buy that. Anyways, I'm not a makeup channel, I just really love makeup, so had to put that in there. And then we were like, ooh, let's, you know, go to Red Lobster, but then we're like, no, we're hungry, let's eat now. So they happen to have a Cheesecake Factory across the hall in the mall that we were at in Madison. We're like, oh, let's go to the Cheesecake Factory. We've never been here before, because I haven't. Like, I honestly thought that the Cheesecake Factory was like a family type style restaurant, and this is like fancy AF, which I was not expecting. But they had gluten-free pasta, and they even had gluten-free cheesecake. So I went off keto for that meal, and I don't feel bad because I never eat out, and when I do, I eat out, it's here in town or where else, and I get keto food. But I wanted gluten-free pasta, damn it, and gluten-free cheesecake, so I got it, and I don't feel guilty. I feel awesome because it was delicious. So yeah, and then we made the trip back home, and I tell you, we didn't get into Watertown until like 10 after 9. It was a long trip, so I am going to insert the vlog portion. Well, let's see, this video is already like 10 minutes long, so actually I think I'm going to do that in another video. And this was just kind of my overview of the trip. Pulling a trailer is not too bad, but it's better if your lights work. So I really appreciate Matt from Dakota Signs and Graphics for letting us use the trailer. But next time I'm definitely going to get like a U-Haul or a trailer, check the lights before we go. Apparently the right side lights were completely cut, so we couldn't even fix them. The left side worked sometimes, but not all the time, and it was pretty much just a crapshoot of when it was gonna work. So I think that's all I have for today. If you have any questions or anything, put them in the comments below and I can answer them the next video. This is a crazy process, and I kept saying, I can't believe we're doing this. I can't believe I'm going to get 350 some pairs of skates. Like, it's still unbelievable to me. I kind of have to pinch myself to make sure that, oh yeah, this is really happening. You're really opening a roller skating rink. Like, crazy. one of the three roller skating rinks in South Dakota. Or I don't know if the Rapid City one is open yet, but then I'll be the fourth roller skating rink in the whole freaking state of South Dakota. How about that? But I think I am going to go. I have so much to get done. I want to go work out because I've been sitting on my ass for 34 hours and 23 minutes. I am tired of sitting. I need to move. So I'm going to go work out. I have to do laundry, catch up on house stuff like cleaning. The bunnies area needs some cleaning. Got to do dishes. Got to get ready for my son's Christmas concert tonight, for which I'm very excited for. And I will go ahead and make the vlog portion of my trip the next video. But like I said, this was just an overview. Oh, excuse me. Oh my God. So if you have anything, throw it in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Please remember, if you like what you see, hit that like button. But anyways, I'm gonna go. So I will talk to you later. Love you. Bye.